wherever you are and whenever you are in your experience of living with pain or illness. I hope that these videos could be helpful for you or maybe helpful for someone that you know. I'm going to let you in on one of the best kept secrets in medicine about how to improve your life if you've got chronic pain or chronic illness, and it's occupational therapy. And you might say to me, well, why should that be a secret? And I do not know the answer to that. I'm confused, actually. I don't know why it's a secret. But I found out about it through a YouTube video with an occupational therapist. Maybe it's just a secret where I live. So I live in England. So maybe, you know, it's a specific feature of the healthcare system here where occupational therapy is kind of underutilized. And possibly you might say to me, oh, I had occupational therapy advice 5 years ago, and yeah, it was pretty good. I liked it. But it's not a secret. But well, in that case, I'm happy for you. I really am. Because for some odd reason, no doctor that I've ever been to see has ever mentioned occupational therapy, which in retrospect is kind of strange. So hopefully, if you're watching this in another country, if you're like in America or India or wherever, hopefully that's not your experience. But if you want to make your chronic pain a bit easier and your life a bit easier, and you haven't heard of occupational therapy, here goes. Functional day-to-day living. And that includes just about anything you can imagine. But a lot of what occupational therapists do is they give you help making it easier to do things like look after yourself. So cook for yourself, personal hygiene, things like that. And a lot of the time they think of different ways of doing things. So in my understanding of it, which obviously this is just, you know, I'm sharing my experience with you, but my understanding of this could be a bit ropey, but they're really quite flexible and inventive, I've found, the ones that I've spoken to. Flexible and inventive about finding solutions, workarounds, and yeah, just generally different ways of doing things. I'll give you some practical examples. Okay, so one example is if you have difficulty getting in and out of the bath or the shower, then there are things you can put in your bath or shower that make life easier for you. So they are shower seats and shower benches. They can make your shower or bath safer to use. You might be watching this and say, I don't have any problem getting in the shower, right? Okay, fair enough. But maybe you know someone who does. One of the things that I've got going on at the moment is orthostatic intolerance, and a lot of elderly people have that. It causes kind of dizziness and wooziness generally, and it can make shower or bathroom kind of a dangerous place to be, right? Nobody wants to fall in the bathroom. You know, an occupational therapist would advise about things like grab rails, or, you know, those big metal rails that you can put at the side of your loo or your bath to make life a little bit safer. Basic examples I can show you. And I might do another video about this, guys, because it kind of works its way into your whole existence when you know about it. Okay, so this is a specially designed knife. Okay, this is where I need to, like, there almost should be music playing in the background so I can show you. It's a specially designed pretty knife. And the idea is for someone with wrist pain, like, you might not know this if you have wrist pain, but because of the design of this handle, it can reduce the amount of pain involved in trying to prepare food. What occupational therapists have found out is that some people, their wrist or even their arm pain can be better if the position can be altered while you're trying to actually do the movement. Now, this knife didn't work very well for me. I bought it. This is a slight issue with some of these aids that I'm going to be talking about, and that you'll probably discover if you go off and look things up. This is quite difficult actually to know whether they're going to work for you until you try them. So it can be expensive, can be costly. I found that this didn't help my arm pain. What I have got on quite well with is a cleaver, which doesn't belong to me. It belonged to a friend of a friend, but I'm able to kind of hold the cleaver and then push downwards a bit on it. So on the good days, I can kind of, you know, get enough force to do that. I actually, one of the movements I find most uncomfortable is this backward retraction often of the shoulder. Another thing you might have difficulty with, particularly with hand pain, is gripping things. So like if you're trying to chop a vegetable, then one hand has to grip it. And very often, you know, if your hand's painful, then you can't actually do gripping. But you can get specialist chopping boards that have spikes sticking out of them. And what you do is you plonk the vegetable on the spikes. That holds it in place. Genius! You guys, you might be watching this and saying to me, look, I don't have any hand problems, okay? I don't have any difficulty with the functionality of my arm, so I'm not gonna watch this video about arm pain. And I get that, but this is just an example that I'm giving you of the way that occupational therapy works. And really what I'm trying to get at is it's about kind of problem solving and maybe finding a slightly different way of doing things that just turns the pain down ever so slightly. You can then save that energy and use it for something else. Okay, so you can save that energy and use it to just like chat maybe to your partner or your spouse, or you can use it for something, you know, like gardening, or I don't know, whatever works for you, right? Whatever your personal thing that you would like to save energy to be able to do maybe during the course of the day, that's kind of what occupational therapy is aiming for. So I'm in favor of that. Here's another example. This is a gadgety type thing made by Dysem. Now, not Dysem, not the vacuum cleaner makers, okay? Dysem, D-Y-C-E-M. And it's kind of astonishing. Okay, it doesn't look great. I'll give you that. It doesn't look fantastic. What it does is it's a jar opener. You can use it to basically grip on anything. So the idea is, here you have this jar. I can't really hold it up very well, but here you have this jar. It's quite difficult to open. And it reduces the amount of force that you have to use to be able to open the jar. Which, if you have a shed load of pain in your hand or your arm or your shoulder or your elbow, reducing the pain by any amount of level is a godsend, particularly with tasks that are repetitious, right? So it's not like when you're chopping vegetables, you can just go chop and you're done. No, you end up having to do that repetitively, right? To actually prepare even a small meal. And I don't need to tell you guys, I'm sure, that as you repeat a painful activity time and time and time again, particularly, you know, if you're pressed for time and you're trying to do it all in one go, the pain ratchets up. In that sense, I think occupational therapy is helping you to do things that you need to do even while you're in pain, but it is also at the same time helping you to do things that you need to do in a way that manages to either keep the, you know, pain at a maintenance level or hopefully just bring it down a little bit. For my money, that's kind of what we need to be aiming for, and it's really helpful. The other great thing about this Dysem thing is you can put it under whatever the object is. Put the object on your countertop. Put your object on your countertop, okay? Say this cushion is the countertop. And then press down with your, if you've got a better level of pain on one arm than the other, you can press down and sort of get your body weight involved a bit, and then use, you know, there's no resistance in this cushion. Obviously it's a cushion, it's soft, but you get the idea, right? I also use this sometimes for holding knives and things. So what you can do is use it as a little gripper if you need, or a spoon, or carrying a bowl. If you don't want to drop the bowl, you can kind of put it in this, and it helps you to grip edges of things. Totally recommend. So those aids are things that I have personal experience of, obviously. But the great thing is that there are shed loads of these aids around. I mean, if you have a lower body thing, you know, you may already use a walking stick. Well, that's an aid. There are more out there, and there are more things that can help us in terms of trying to, I don't know, get dressed, leave the house, go somewhere, you know, you name it, there's something that can maybe just reduce the effort levels or make something actually achievable. Like, I came across this amazing thing on eBay the other day, which is a kind of suction cup with a metal arm that holds your hairdryer up high on the wall, right? And it just props it up at a height so you can stand underneath it and get your hair dry. There are also very reputable, like, healthcare suppliers, that companies that just do this. I can put the links to some of them in the description below. When you start putting these terms into Google, the names of these companies will come up. There are also online lovely videos by occupational therapists who've just put, you know, they've just put videos online about how to use different products, and some of them are on YouTube. So have a look at those, because if you do buy one of these products, it's kind of nice to actually have an explainer on how to use them. Yeah, adapt it, change it, you know. One of the things I think that people really don't know about living with chronic pain or chronic illness is it, we kind of do learn to be really flexible and resilient. Just because, you know, we deal with a lot of uncertainty anyway. But I think possibly that's an underappreciated skill that we've built up, you know, which is, how do you work around the situations that you find yourself in? Guys, I hope these tips were useful for you, and I hope that they're a little bit helpful. Go easy on yourselves. Go gently on yourself if you can, and I hope to see you soon.